Alright, guys. Welcome back, everybody. It is time for the start of the finals. We're going to get into the server here. We've got the Breakdancing Midgets and Team 7. They're going to be facing off in this best of three finals. First map up is Inferno. Dego, what do you make of this matchup?
I'm really excited to see this matchup. These two have definitely been our two standout teams from the group stages. With Team 7 only dropping two rounds in two games, winning both of their games 16-1, which is quite a feat in itself. And then we've got definitely Breakdancing Midgets, which were pushed quite close by the Vikings in the first game, and then showed a very strong performance in the last one against Will Smith's Bastard Children. I think it will be very interesting to see, especially if you haven't seen Team 7 play yet. Yeah. I'm looking forward to see what they have to offer.
Yeah, we haven't seen anything from Team 7. They've played both of their matches behind the scenes. Dominating performances, yes, but it is fair to say that the teams they played were less experienced than they are, so... I know personally Crazy Pingu, and he's got a team put together of his friends. You know, Crazy Pingu plays a lot of CSGO, so, he's probably got a pretty solid team. It's gonna be a very close matchup. I wouldn't be surprised to see this game go three maps. And if not, they're gonna be very close games. I mean, it's gonna be exciting. This is a very exciting final here. And like I said, Inferno is the map. I love Inferno. I think it's an awesome map. I'm looking forward to seeing how it goes. Dago, what side do you feel is the stronger side to start with?
The T side on Inferno is definitely the more favorable of the two. Since it is just because of the way the choke points work, especially on B, there's only one way into B from the T side, really. We had the knife round. Did I miss the knife round?
No, the knife round has not started yet. This is just another warm-up, I believe.
Okie doke. I think it'll be interesting to see how that pans out. I think, you know, the CTs will be looking to pick up as many rounds as possible on that side. Here we go with the knife round. But yeah, I think it definitely favors the CT. The Ts will want to get six rounds, maybe. That for them might be a good half. Once the ball gets rolling on the CT side, it can be very, very strong, and it gets very difficult to stop, especially when the economy gets going on the CT.
Well said, I agree. So the knife round is underway. We're gonna have a little dance party in mid here as the two teams decide who's going to take what side.
Divine Stealth actually getting stabbed in the back by his teammate there. Does get a knife off on Tempora though.
Teams are just dancing. No one wanting to commit.
Oh, crazy thing.
We got the first here. And Pingu comes up from behind, takes one out.
In a 2v1, as you're saying here now. That's Team 7 pick up the last seat at last T player, and we should be on to the first round. I'd expect them to try and go for the CT to start with, but it's interesting to see whether they go for T if they're coming in off their back of their two very convincing wins on high confidence. You know, it'd be interesting to see.
Yeah, I mean, they've got to be feeling pretty good. I mean, they won their two games very easily, but also they're definitely aware of Breakdancing Midgets and what they've been doing. So, they probably were able to catch a bit of that last match. So they know what to expect.
Indeed. Interesting to see what the T's do in this first round, whether they do a fast B hit or maybe a slow A hit. It'd be interesting to see. I'd expect if they do go B, it'll be fast. I don't think they'll do a slow B hit on the pistol round. Just explode onto the site, try and overwhelm the two players that have gone there from T7. But it looks like they're going for some mid control. Crazy Pingo taking a huge amount of damage just now.
FTK Rage with the first shot into Hussein. And T's trying to push up into Banana here. They've got two guys holding them back, but you know what? Divine goes down.
They're into a 4-on-4 situation here. The TTs have taken control of the site with two players incredibly lit for the CTs.
FTK lurking here. Lurking in construction. He might catch somebody out here. Oh. Oh, and Red Eagle wins the duel.
Yeah, all the CTs trying to retake from the same angle. I don't know whether that was the best option, but they didn't get anyone to pick banana. But the rotate was a little slow. They all sort of slowed down in the CT, unfortunately. But two T's are incredibly lit here.
Yeah, but they're quickly running out of time. No kit on them.
The bomb
Even
is
though
ticking,
they got all the kills. Oh, and they actually don't kill everybody. But yeah, they would not have had enough time for the defuse. Breakdancing Midgets, the terrorists will get the first round of this match. And that is a good start. That is an important first round, especially as T-side. Like Dego was saying earlier, the CTs have a huge advantage here. You know, defending their bombs, so it's good to get the first round and hopefully be able to build off that, as now they can purchase a little bit of weapons and the CTs have to reserve to their pistols.
Yeah, as you can see, the T's are going towards the apartments here, and the CTs have actually gone for a full save, whether they have something planned for the third round, whether they get a buy in that round, or they're just going to try and... Nice shot from DSB there on the head of King Cronus there.
Yeah,
very
excellent
nice.
Headshot. Nice defense, and they're going to back up here and push out from lower. Double kill by Temporo. He takes two of the rotating CTs out. We still got one on site though, and look, they're gonna rotate and they're gonna run right into Divine. Does Divine know this is coming? Oh yeah, he can hear him. But they were expecting
the angle,
it. And now there's only one guy left, and he is in pit. Temporo lurking.
May look to just save this MP7. He is on 6 HP and cannot take any engagement really, unfortunately. Considering the investment in this round, I'm interested to see what they have planned for the next round, or whether they'll go for a big buy in that first gun round in the fourth round.
Yeah, DSP is just gonna save here, try to hold on to his weapon, but we've already got Temporo looking for that kill. He's gonna see if he can catch him out here and take this gun out of his hands and continue to damage their economy and build on theirs. 6 HP, I mean. Can he find him in pits?
So very close, but he looks down right now. It's an interesting paint gun,
unfortunately.
Oh, and
he does get him! And he will get that kill.
Yeah, it looks like there's another full save coming in from the CTs here. Which is a wise decision. Yeah, but they'll have a very strong buy in the next round.
Yeah, and especially playing against a team like this, I mean, half buys are kind of risky, especially when you have, you know, the team's building an economy. So they're just gonna save it here. Try to make something happen. He's gonna push in for a B play. Divine quickly takes one out. Look, Hussein unaware, but is able to turn around Red Eagle with a nice shot on Divine.
The shot through the smoke by DSB there. Nice headshot on the Die Bradley. Hussein, they have picked two CTs who are trying to push through construction. It's just Leo who gets a kill on Hussein here. Picks up an MP7. Looking to deal a bit more damage to the T-Dog.
And, you know, that was very doable for the CTs to bring that back, but the T's will take it. And now we have a full buy coming out from Team 7. They're gonna be able to buy out their guns. My guest speaker, Dominic, this is my channel, please. You're the guest.
So we have an AWP coming out on both sides here. King Cronus stick with this MP7. Panicking a passive hold, two towards Arch, two on B, and then one in pit. Waiting for them to push into their line of sight.
Nice shot, Pingyu. On to Temporo.
The bomb makes his way into apartments, and they've smoked off apartments the CTs have. see what the T's have planned for this round.
Many footsteps though, and Leo's gonna be able to catch on as they're just right on the other side of this wall right here. And they're gonna be able to hear all that commotion.
As you can see, Divine Stealth is in a prime position to rotate fast to A or fast to B. He's kind of in CT spawn. Very strong position to be in. Support either side.
If he misses his shot, he's gonna be forced to back out of there. T's are gonna have to push now. Flash will try to smoke to slow him down. Divine Cell's trying to hold off there, but it's a 2v1, and Pingu gets a nice shot there.
By Bradley, unable to kill that Leo, dancing around the pillar there, connects with the side. DSB flanks these T's.
And now it is just Die Bradley. What can he do? He does have the bomb, but it is a 5-on-1. Make that a 4-on-1. They know where he is. Do they know he's rotating though? Oh, well, they run out of time, so he's gonna save there. 4-on-1, not a great situation to be in, but he does stay alive with his gun, which is nice.
The T's choose to. They're in a position where they can actually force into this round if they want to. They've got the money to do it. We go back after the 3-round win. As you can see, they have just with pretty much full utility on everyone. 3 AWPs for the CTs at the moment now. Triple AWP setup already. This could break the CT economy if they lose this round.
Yeah, this is a huge investment play. And they're forced to back out as there is a B play coming in here. They need to back it up. Smokes go out to try to stall a T-side.
Nice spray by Temper there, just spraying at the edge of the smoke and catches Leo as he tries to cross or peek and get some information in mid. But as you can see, the T's are all in still banana. CTs have completely relinquished control of A now, turtling up on B. Be interesting to see if the terrorists do make their way into A now and plant. Be exceptionally hard for the CTs to retake with these 3 orbs.
They do have DSB coming back to defend the sites. Him and Pingu are going to be greeted by a lot of people. They're going very slow, 40 seconds left. So with 4 people left, they are splitting their defense, which favors the T side. I mean, technically this is a 4-on-2 right here. DSB misses the first shot, and Red Eagle takes him out, and now they have control of site. Crazy Pingu gonna try to hold him off, he misses that shot. TT's coming in for the rotate.
Very difficult position for the CTs now, stuck on arch side. As we want, one tries to take control of a short at top mid. Blast the rifle down, and FTK just Crazy Pingu now on low HP, might look to save.
And he will. He's gonna get out of there. 4T's still alive. He is out. And Breakdancing Midgets get a round back after losing that last one. And nice rotate there by the T's. You know, nothing was happening on B site. The CT's over-rotated very quickly without seeing the bomb. And the T's were able to come back and, you know, take control very easily with a 4-on-2 situation.
Crazy Pingu peeking where he didn't need to there and loses his AWP. That's a lot of money lost there. If you can see, there's they could buy in the next round if they so choose to, just DSB low on cash at the moment, but that triple AWP almost backfired on them there.
Yeah, that was a very expensive round for the CTs, and they lost everybody there.
Yep, it's just a full save coming in from the CTs.
Nipara lurking in mid. He's trying to just stall the T's, I think. CT's. As they set up for a B play. He might get caught out from behind here. Crazy Pingu lurking in that smoke. He's gonna make his way into apartments. They keep lurking around each other. So the action goes on in B site. They do take control of it. They take everybody out. And now it is just down to one on the full save. They were able to manage a kill on Die Bradley, though. 'Tis better than nothing. DSB,
yeah.
Just gonna try and maybe get some kills. They're just flashing away. They've got all the utility in the world. They can just slow him down. But yeah, there's not much he can do here. Win. He gets taken down by Red Eagle. Rip candy. How much did you bet, Jetty? TT's putting together a full buy here. They've got the op on Crazy Pinger. Just one op this time. Looks like he's going to be taking it mid.
Yeah, so hold the same angle he did on the first rifle round with the orb. See if he can get the same kind of luck he did the first round. Get a couple of picks to start the round off. It was very, very good picks.
Myself spots the tease, throws the smoke down, gets himself out of there. Knows that there's people in banana, and look at this. We've got some tease coming into mid there. Red Eagle unable to trade. Still got a Leo over there in the corner.
Just the smoke slightly then. Red Eagle's able to push up mid, and Leo does actually pick him up there. Into a 5-on-3 as the rest of the tees move towards B.
Now they're electing to rotate, but there are three CTs on A though, so this is actually not going to be any easier for the Ts. They're going to be trying to come down mid here. That smoke is going to signal to the CTs that the Ts are coming. Pingu holding the corner, he's got to back up, he gets overrun. Nice shot onto Hussein though. But look at this, the bomb actually sneaked by. And he's gonna get this plant down. I don't know what happened here. But Dai Bradley sneaks by Pingu, gets that plant down.
As we see the CTs try and retake site here, they've got one nade remaining. They can land this nade on.
Now it's a 3-on-1. Dai Bradley's in big trouble. He's just trying to stall for time. He gets taken out with it. USP. It's some combination of letters. Some combination of letters there. And they're able to get the fuse and the second round in the books for Team 7.
As we see another full buy coming out for the breakdancing midgets here. Just the MP7 on Dai Bradley, though. Interesting choice, considering he would have had enough money for a rifle if he so chose to invest in it. As we see them push towards A.
Yep, make an aggressive push onto apartments. We see DSB here. Okay, stop with the face palms in chat. Chat, please.
Looks like we might see him some action here. DSB waiting for him to push upstairs. He sees him. But the guy falls back and he's just gonna flash himself out.
No, actually, he's playing super aggressively. He's getting a lot of information. Hasn't died yet. They haven't tagged him down. It was a 3-on-1. He does get out. He goes down into pit. He does have some info. I wonder if he saw the bomb. The CTs did not rotate there.
One drops down into pit. He's hidden in the corner. He's
died. There's nothing he could do there, but they did get that trade off.
So we have the bomb plant going down on A, surely in a second. And just crazy Pingu on our side. The remaining other two CTs on. There he goes. DSB confirming it.
Server lag. No.
Yeah.
Pings look fine to me.
Interesting. Might be on client side then. Unfortunately, he did seem like he was stuttering around a little. Red Eagle does pick off Divine State, and it's just down to FT Rage. He'll probably look to save in T-Spawn.
Ray takes a bit mid is building a nice T-half here. I mean, already 6 rounds. And with CT usually being the very dominating side in this map,
Yeah, but interesting position now that the money for the CTs is a little all over the place. You know, you've probably got two or three people that can rebuy, and then just Leo on a pistol. But if they choose to buy, that is, be interesting to see what they decide to do here, because this will put Breakdancing Midgets most likely on a seventh round if they full save, which they are doing. No, they're forcing their opponent. They've got three M4s, a FAMAS, and just a pistol on Leo, who himself is down to $1,700.
They're probably gonna flash himself in. Wins the fight against Crazy Pingu.
Leo but, saw the barrel of Hussein in apps there, able to take him down.
And now, the girl will lurk, but loses that fight.
Three remaining T's stacked at the top of mid looking for a B.
Yep, they're looking to push into B. We got two CTs in the back of sight. Nice spray by Die Bradley, can't get the other one. And the CTs in this game is going back and forth now.
It's a very nice crossfire.
Sorry, go ahead.
I was just saying, a very nice crossfire set up by the CTs there. As the T's push through T-spawn into sight, they just pincered them and they were able to pick them off one by one, and they were just able to, and the T's were only to get the one killing response. Very well done by them there.
Crazy Pingu picks up the op, no action. Red Eagle looking to make something happen. Divine Stealth lurking too much ahead, and Red Eagle peeks around that smoke to take him out. Now there's just one person left on CT. Is it gonna force them to rotate in the B side? You know, usually you only have two people on B, and with that kill, I mean, B is pretty vulnerable, but it looks like a CT is rotating over there. And T still wanting to go to A. They get another pick and another pick. And both CTs are now just left on B, with Red Eagle giving them a hard time, so they're gonna give it an easy bomb plant. CT's in a bad position.
They're probably gonna look to save here if they can stop any of the T's advances, which they will surely try and push them here just to get these rifles out of the hand, because the CT's in a very tough position for their economy, having just picked up one round, and then this back and forth between rounds definitely favors the T's economy, making it because it's slightly more expensive to be a CT with the guns and the diffuse kit and all that kind of stuff. Be interesting to see what they decide here.
And now the hunt begins. Pingu takes one. Can he stay alive with this weapon? They're on a manhunt for him. Trying to hang on, he does not. Seven rounds for T. This is looking good so far for the Breakdancing Midgets. And maybe, you know, Team 7's confidence, you know, dominating their games in the group rounds could be hurting them a little bit here.
Yeah, unfortunately off the back of that round, losing those two rifles does mean they're on a full save. Looking like we're getting a B rush here. Temperu with a nice spray.
And everybody, that was just a slaughter fest. Temperu mows everyone down there with one HP to survive. And right, this is gonna just be an eco here.
It looks like the Breakdancing Midgets should be able to pick up 8th round here and go into the half with a round lead at least.
Bomb has been planted. But yeah, look, just lurking, trying to find something. He's gonna want to probably pick up a gun here. There's no point in saving this pistol, is there?
Well, he does have body armor and he's invested quite a bit. He's probably gonna try and look at the bottom of T-stairs or something here, or maybe push him into banana a little and try and pick up a rifle if he can.
I mean, he's got somebody rushing down, so he might be able to pick up a kill. Nope. Hussein with that close range shot takes him out.
Yeah, unfortunately, Leo, he would have liked to have been able to save that pistol if at all possible, because now he's the only person on Team 7 who can't really purchase a weapon and armor in this round, unfortunately. Maybe just a pistol and armor, which he gets a 5-7 and body armor and a few nades. A little bit of miscommunication on the CT side there. As you've seen, Divine Stealth actually didn't pick up anything, and he's just run back to a CT spawn, and unfortunately missed the buy time.
And now he's caught out of sight. I mean, they could go in right now. I mean, they don't know this, but you know, now he's just all he's left with a pistol. He's outside the site. I mean, but they don't even check the corner. Hussein mows him down eventually, but costly kill there. They don't even check that corner, they didn't even smoke it off.
I'm only just pushing into sight now. Quite left. Leo not able to capitalize on Hussein having his knife out there with pushing into
sight.
And
look at that, two kills. This is an even 2-on-2 match now. The bomb does go down. And this is 1-on-1. A 1-on-1 matchup. Check in their corners. No, I don't think either one is sure where the other one is. No, they might know now. Nice smoke there. And a nice return molly. That's gonna be hard for him to get to the bomb. That's gonna might buy enough time. He does have a kit, but it's gonna be close, and Red Eagle takes him down. Nice Molotov there to just buy a little bit of time, push through that smoke, prevent the defuse, even with the kit. I mean, maybe if he had stuck in and taken the damage, he might have been able to get it, but nice play there in that 1-on-1 situation by Red Eagle.
Yeah, a nice commanding lead for Breakdancing Midgets here now. They've completely broken the CT economy. They're back on another save, and they should be able to go into the half with at least a double point score in terms of rounds as they take banana control.
Myself picking up on those sounds. They've got 3 stacks on B this time. Leo playing close. He's gonna look for a quick little headshot here. Oh, and he's gonna get the opportunity! He doesn't get any kills out of that. He does get a couple shots off, but no kills. He had a great chance there to really, like, turn the tide in that round. I mean, he could have picked up 1 or 2 kills just like that. His back was turned and everything, but could not secure any of those kills. Bomb goes down, 2 people left, no guns. Red Eagle moving in, but he's super lit. 6-7 HP on him. And everybody getting tagged down, but nobody dying. And there goes 2 quickly. I mean, Temporo could have had, or DSP could have had everyone there with super lit people. Temporo down with 1 HP, Red Eagle had 7 there.
Yeah, I think it's just that just shows the kind of position that Breakdancing Midgets, that they feel like they have the confidence and the ability to go on and take on these guys whilst being on such low HP.
Yeah, I mean, they definitely have the money, they have the rounds to do so. Why not, you know, continue punishing Team 7? Hurt their economy.
Yeah. But it looks like we've got another buy round here. If Team 7 want to have a chance at all in their T-Harp at all, they really need to be looking to be picking up these last 2 rounds as CT. And as we see action at the top of mid.
Find self misses shot. Nice shot there. Tomorrow drops. Red Eagle tried to push up. Pingu was waiting for it. The 2 CTs and B were playing very aggressive. And this is looking good for CTs all of a sudden. Now it's just down to King Cronus with the bomb. 4 guys left. He gets tagged. And T's pick up a round with 1 round to go in the half. They could bring it up to 5-10. Which obviously is not great for CT, but it's, you know, it's reasonable. It's definitely doable to bring this back.
Yeah, hopefully if they do pick up these last two rounds, they might be able to take the momentum from those two rounds into the pistol round on the in the next half, and hopefully be able to pick up a couple of rounds just to sort of calm the nerves, bring it back to maybe 8-10, and then we might have a game on our hands.
Nice little battle going on there, Banana. T's are trying to push up here. Uh-oh, they've got the auto sniper. This is trouble. Nice timing, but can't make anything happen there. Nice timing. Divine Stealth gets flashed. Can't do anything about that. They have taken over site, and now the rotate is coming on here.
DSP on the big flank here. Will they think there's someone on the flank already? So far, pick up the kill on King Cronus as the bomb goes down.
And yeah, now it's just Red Eagle with the auto sniper. Now it's back down to a 101, but this time, Divine Stealth will take it and easily get this defuse. So we've got a 10-5 half in favor of the Breakdancing Midgets.
Breakdancing Midgets will definitely be the team of the happier team going to this half-time here. Having 10 rounds on your T side in Inferno is a very good job, and you'll be kicking yourself as a member of Team 7 right now, having letting a few of those rounds slip that were very close, just unfortunate on a couple of occasions. I'll be looking forward to seeing what they have planned for their pistol round here, because a lot will depend on this, because if they win it, they could possibly bring this back to only be 2 rounds down. If they lose it, they could easily be another 8 rounds behind Breakdancing Midgets.
Let's see what the Team 7 wants to do on the T side to start the half. They're playing very slow. I guess they're either talking out what they want to do, looking for aggression. Sometimes CTs like to rush down Banana the first round just to catch the T's off guard.
The CTs on B are playing very split up, just like Bradley pushed down Banana, and then King Cronus playing passively on site.
Hey Bradley, looking to fish for information, but he's actually going to get caught out, and now the B rush is on. It is just King Cronus holding up the half. King Cronus getting FTK down, and he's still staying alive. He's causing a lot of trouble, and this allows the CT to rotate.
Bomb drop though, very nice kill by Hussein. Yeah, it's crazy being who tried to get into sight.
And it's a 3-on-3.
Yeah, and the bomb stuck in oranges. They're trying to plant it now by the sounds of it. Some very nice headshots coming in there. As the
yeah, and now, well, Breakdancing Midgets get the first run of this half, and that might be the momentum they need to win this first map of a best of three.
But that bomb plant does mean that if the T's do wish to full save this round, they will only have to surrender maybe the one round to the Ecos. They do full save this round, they'll be able to buy it in the next one and have a pretty competent buy in the next round.
Yeah, that bomb plant, definitely important. Getting a little bit of money for the T's. What's up, King Kabaj? I'm here. Yeah, you can't see me, I'm sorry. Don't forget what it looked like. T's inching their way towards apartments. Got Hussein here lurking. Tenparo lurking as well. Hussein's gonna get that first kill, and the T's are gonna back up. They're like, whoa there. Whoa there! But Red Eagle's waiting for that in mid. And now he's just gonna smoke and play passively.
Tempura playing aggressive in apps, getting a nice couple of 2 kills there. Unfortunately, the terrorists are not able to punish him for that aggression as they try and fall back.
And now we'll see probably full buys from both teams.
Interesting to see whether the CTs choose to upgrade at all. Just the one upgrade coming in from Red Eagle there, as we see the buy coming in from the T's. Auto shotgun and DSP. It'll be interesting to see where he decides to take this.
Probably apartments. That's usually the best place to maneuver a shotgun. He's probably looking to get some close range base shots. And Hussein's gonna lurk here again. Nice flash there! And nothing DSP can do. Completely flash the timing by Hussein. Nice kill there. Rip, shoddy dream. We've got some action going on in Banana. Looks like that's where the T's want to go, but okay, maybe they decide to go elsewhere. Divine Stealth pushing up in mid. They know Hussein's in that apartment. He's actually going to peek at this timing. Oh, and Hussein does not get the shot. Is he going to peek for it again? Now he knows somebody's there. Oh, no, and they do push in the mid, and they do get control. You know, we've got King Cronus here on the rotate.
Slice is clear, but they do have a player on apps, which could be key to this retake here.
And now he's just waiting for his team to get into position for the retake. That was a beautiful flash. And the T's will clean it up and pick up the rounds. The first full gun round of this half, I should say. And can we believe in the comeback? Do we want to give Team 7 some energy, guys? Who are you guys giving your energy to right now? You want to see the comeback right here in the first map?
As we see the Breakdancing Midgets do force up in this round, 3M4s on show. UMP and a 5-7 for the remaining two players. Be interesting to see if they do lose this one, they will have a very broken economy, unfortunately. But they do have a lot of rounds to play with.
They've really taken some fire there. He likes to walk back. Can't see anything going on through that smoke. Still trying to gather info. He might have seen the bomb there. I mean, he's got a lot of action going on in Banana. CT are aware of this, and they do have a man rotating around.
They do have people pushing down mid as well. Good kill by Red Eagle now. He's in a position to cut off any kind of rotation they had planned.
Se.V.en looking to take this spot over, but they've got three CTs already over here. I mean, the CTs have already rotated. It's gonna be hard to take. Some nice calls by Team 7. But Hussein, the boy, with the ump. Arguably the best weapon in CSGO, the ump.
Doing work. Huge.
CTs will take that round.
Hugely important trio of kills there from Hussein. Two players went down for two entry kills for Team 7 there. Two very important entry kills, and then Hussein comes in huge with a couple of headshots there with the UMP. Stopping that push into the site and completely shutting down any plans that the Team 7 had.
And with the eco, they're gonna go for a B rush, and look at this, there's no T's! There's no CT's in B! Without a smoke though, they are getting fired on. From truck. They get that bomb down. Red Eagle with an encounter with Leo, he takes him out. It is a 3-on-3, but this is definitely favoring the CT's to take this over. And nice kill there by Divine Stealth. He now picks up a gun. He's gonna smoke out construction. Back to a 2-on-2. Nice trade there. Now this is a 1-on-1 FTK with 1 HP. Oh my god, can he hold on? No.
Is the bomb too far to tick though? He should have it here as a kit.
This is going to be close. Oh, yeah, and just job. In time. Just in the nick of time. Alright. Two rounds left for the Breakdancing Midgets to secure the first map in this best of three. Team 7 having a hard time on this Inferno map. Can't get anything going.
Yeah, unfortunately, they've not just found any traction on this map at all. Hopefully, they'll find some now that they've got some rifles again, with a full buy coming out for them. We'll see how it goes. They seem to be going towards A a little bit more now. As Di Bradley takes an aggressive peek in Banana, and they trade nicely in Banana. Actually, they take both players down in Banana.
Yeah, now B is wide open. And Pingu's gotta be like, oh, and I missed smoke there. And they elect to go back, and they, oh, this is actually some tricky mind play right here. They think the CTs are gonna rotate, and they've called this right, but here we go. Red Eagle still staying around the A site, just in case. And just in case this happens. The keys rolling in, Red Eagle puts a stop to one of them, but they are gonna get the bomb down. It is gonna be a 2-on-3 retake.
As we see both of the CTs coming from our side to try and get the site, there's one coming up through Torch now as one drops into pit, and an eye on there, you know, some information as to where the players are.
Nice post-plant positions. I mean, you've got someone in pit, he goes down. But, I mean, Divine Stealth is in a place that's, you know, it's near impossible. I mean,
yeah, the bomb's planted there as well.
Yeah. So basically what's happening here is he can hear the plan, and anytime he wants to, he'll peek and take that out. But I don't think he's going to have enough time to defuse that bomb.
Nope. Well played by Divine Stealth there. Unfortunately, he went down, but he did just keep him off the bomb for just enough time for them to win the round.
Yeah, that was within milliseconds right there. Just enough time. Ugh, Keltry, what are you talking about? Oh my god, Keltry. You're so salty. Can we check Keltry's salt in chat? Can we get a salt check? And now CTs are forced to eco. BSB opens up the round with a kill. FTK with another kill, and a good start here for the T's, but look at that, Red Eagle and Hussein both pick up frags. King Cronus the only one defending the site, and he's gonna take out FTK as these guys are peeking one by one. They're not using their numbers as an advantage, and King Cronus takes out another one with a sick headshot. The CZ's back, boys. And now it's just up to Leo. It is a 2-on-2, or a 2-on-1, and Red Eagle just has a Deagle.
The CTs are rather split up here. See if he can make it into a 2-1-v-1 situation. Hussein Du Bois does cut off the attempted rotation away, and puts Breakdancing Midgets at the match point. That was an eco by Breakdancing Midgets. That will be a round
one. And they had opened the round with two frags, but quick trades, and, you know, not making anything happen. Breakdancing Midgets in a great position to take this game as the Team 7's gonna have to end this match on a eco round and, you know, hope for a miracle. We'll be getting the next maps for you guys to vote on very shortly. Red Eagle with the aggression. Only gets one there. Tumparo there. Though is there to take another frag. And a Kobe. And what is going on there? Di Bradley just AFK. But this match ends on a Kobe. Breakdancing Midgets take the first map, guys. 16-7. We're gonna get voting on the next maps. Map 2, guys, will start in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.